I remember working with a director in New York, five-time Emmy Award winner, sports director, and after 10 minutes of fencing broadcasts, he just turned back to me and said, "Barna, this is really tough." During the competition, I'm sitting behind the director. If it's an experienced director, I'm just watching and enjoying. But if you work with a television crew for the first time ever and they've never done fencing before, then they cannot judge. I need to give them some assistance from behind. Key person is the director. The other key elements in production are the EVS operators. All the slow motions come from an EVS. The picture engineer changes the sensibility of the camera. Sound is very important, so that means that you can hear the audience from the background, for example, and you can hear actually the fencing moving from right to left. Plenty of jobs to do and plenty of people needed for that. The main challenge in television is to show what's going on, so the cameraman really have a tough job, and the slow motions, as we show something that you cannot even see with your own eyes. If you do not show slow motion, then you are missing a very, very important part of the fencing broadcast. Partly because you cannot show the action again, and partly because fencing is really, really attractive. The 1 minute break within the fights, usually I use that 1 minute to show a 30 second clip of not really the action itself, but with the super slow motion cameras, the close-ups, you know, sweating faces, hands, the weapons, it's amazing. Shoelaces flying in the air, they are really exciting, they really look good. It's tough because you need to make an immediate decision. And obviously you can make a quicker decision if you have some idea what's going on the piste. For example, in foil, you can show a close-up even during live action, because the legs are not important for foil in case there is a hit made. But in epee, you cannot do the same thing because you might miss the hit on one of the feet. These are tiny little things that they need to learn, but they do. Fencing differs a lot from other sports. I think sports television people are always prepared for the extraordinary. I mean, sports is always about something that is unexpected. They have the nerves for that, and they have the eyes for that. It's very important. In fencing, there are a lot of hits made. If you do not show the action immediately after it happens, then you are late. Then you most probably you will never show it again.